Hello everyone, in this video I will explain you how to analyze cables with reference to one example. Now here the type of numerical is analysis of cable when both supports are at same level. Okay, so we'll see directly numerical. The cable segment support the loading as shown in figure. Determine the support reactions and maximum tension in segment of cable. Now this example is given to us. Cable is A, C, D, B. Now cable is supported at point A and B by using hinge supports. The distance between point A and C, which is horizontal distance, is 3 meter. Between point C and D it is 7 meter, and between point D and B it is 4 meter. The sag at point C is given to us, which is YC. This distance from point A to C, it is 4 meter. Now we will draw free body diagram for the given problem. Now look, you have to show the same shape. Instead of just showing these supports, we will show reactions. In my previous video related to basic concepts of cables, I have explained you how to show these reactions. So in the line of AC, you have to extend this line, and this line comes in second quadrant. So my horizontal component of RA will act towards left side, and my vertical component of RA will act vertically upward. Similarly, at point B, you have to extend this line BD ahead. So it comes in first quadrant. In first quadrant, horizontal component will be towards right side and vertical component will be towards upward side. Okay, now between AC there will be tension T1, CD, T2, DB, T3. The sag or deflection at point C is given, which is YC, and it is 4 meter. So show all these forces. The load acting at point C is 500 Newton and at point D it is 400 Newton in magnitude. Now after showing this active and reactive forces, we will solve this numerical. First step we have followed, we have drawn separate free body diagram for the given problem. Now we have to apply equilibrium conditions. Now we have to apply three equilibrium conditions. Since this is non-concurrent force system, all forces are not acting at one common point. So we will use equilibrium condition summation fx equals to 0, summation fy equals to 0, and summation m equals to 0. Now look, we will apply first equilibrium condition, summation fx equals to 0. So I will follow some sign convention. I will consider forces going towards right side will be positive, forces going towards left side will be negative. So if you observe this free body diagram, there are only two forces which are horizontal, ax and bx. According to my sign convention, ax is going towards left side, so it will be negative. Bx is going towards right side, so it will be positive. So my equation will become minus ax plus bx equals to 0. So my equation will become ax equals to bx, and I will treat this as my equation number 1. Next, I will apply second equilibrium condition, summation fy equals to 0. So for this I will use sign convention. Vertically upward force is positive, vertically downward force is negative. So again, observe this free body diagram. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 forces which are acting in vertical direction. So according to sign convention, look, plus AY, minus 500, minus 400, plus BY must be equals to 0. So here AY and BY both are unknown. So my equation will become AY plus BY equals to 900. So let us treat this equation as equation number 2. Next, I will use third equilibrium condition, which is summation MA equals to 0. And for this, I will use sign convention as clockwise moment negative, anti-clockwise moment positive. Already, as I have discussed, you can use any sign conventions, doesn't matter, your answers will be same. Now look, observe this free body diagram. You can take moment about point A, or you can take moment about point B. Now here I am taking moment about point A. Since AY, AX and BX, all these three forces are passing through this common point A, moment of all these three forces will be zero about point A. So I am going to neglect these three forces. Now consider this 500 Newton force and 400 Newton force. These forces are going to rotate in clockwise direction about point A. And if you consider BY force, it is going to rotate in anti-clockwise direction about point A. So moment of these two forces will be negative in nature and moment of this BY will be positive in nature according to my sign conventions. Now look, so since these two forces are vertical, consider its distance from point A, horizontal one. Now consider moment of 500 Newton force, it is going to rotate in clockwise direction, so minus 500 into 3. Again, minus 400 into 3 plus 7, 10 meter, so minus 400 into 10. Consider this force, it is anti-clockwise in nature, so plus BY into distance becomes 14 meter, must be equals to 0. Now same equation I have written over here. So from this equation, unknown is BY. So you will get value of BY by using this equation and it is acting vertically upward. Now use equation 2, which is AY plus BY equals to 900. Now we know value of BY. So here you will get value of AY again, which is acting vertically upward. Now to determine value of AX and BX, we have to consider part of cable and again we have to use one equilibrium condition of moment and we have to find value of AX and BX. Now which part is to be considered? Now remember, you have to consider the part of cable where sag is known to us. Already I have explained this part in my previous video of theory related to this cable. Now if you observe this figure, we know sag at point C, which is YC equals to 4 meter. So I will consider the segment AC to determine the remaining force AX. Now here I have drawn separate diagram for explaining you. Look, this is AX, this is AY. Now we know value of AY, already we have calculated this value. We know the distance of point A and C, which is 3 meter, and sag between A and C is 4 meter. At point C there is force of 500 Newton. Now where moment is to be taken? Now if you take moment about point A, moment of these two forces will become 0 and my aim will not get satisfied because my aim is to determine value of AX. So let us take moment about point C and equate it to 0. So already we have considered these sign conventions, clockwise moment negative, anti-clockwise moment positive. Now if you consider this 500 Newton force, its moment about point C is 0. Now consider force AX, it is going to rotate in anti-clockwise direction and its distance from point C is YC. So its moment will be plus AX into YC. Now consider this AY force, it is going to rotate in clockwise direction, so it will create negative sign for this moment and its distance from point C is 3 meter. So its moment will be minus AY into 3 and according to equilibrium condition, this moment must be equals to 0. Now here AX is unknown for me, YC is known, which is 4 meter, AY already we have calculated, we know the distance between A and C, which is 3 meter, so unknown is AX. So by using this equation, you will get value of AX and already we have shown this force is acting towards left side. Now we know equation 1, which is AX equals to BX, so value of AX and BX both are same. Only BX is in opposite direction. So you have to show this force which is acting towards right side. Now my next step is to find support reactions. So RA is AX square plus AY square. Now we know value of these two components. So substitute these values, you will get value of reaction acting at point A, which is 633.93 newton. Now I have to calculate reaction at point B. So RB is square root of BX square plus BY square. We know these two values, so substitute those values, you will get reaction at point B, which is 546.82 newton. Now my aim is to find maximum tension. I have already explained you in my previous video, maximum tension acts where the inclination is maximum with respect to horizontal axis and it always acts near the support. Now compare values of RA and RB. RA is 633.93 newton, RB is 546.82 newton. So my maximum tension will act at point A and its magnitude will be equals to RA. So maximum tension will develop at point A. So my T max will be equals to reaction at point A and it will act in the segment AC, which is nearer to support A, and it will be 633.93 newton. Hope you have understood this problem. Thank you.